Now that I have a nicely neutralized color in my image, I can go about and do some creative color correction. For example, let's say that I think that his skin tones are now too pale, too pasty. I want to add some red back to them. I can apply another effect, such as color correction, hue saturation, limit it to just the red values, and increase the saturation of just the reds and give him a little bit better skin tone. Maybe even give it a slight adjustment, give him a little bit more of a yellow reddish skin there, before and after. And you'll notice, since I have a neutral image to start with, and I'm adjusting just the reds, that the rest of my shot's not shifting. The whites and blacks are staying the same. I'm only playing with the skin tones. This was before on the whole shot and after. Much better. Big improvement. So color balance is really good for this sort of corrective action. But of course, you can use color balance for creative actions as well. For example, here's a scene of sky and trees. And I've got sort of a reddish tint to the bark, bluish tint to the sky, and green to my mid-tones here with the trees. I'll select my footage and apply effect, color correction, color balance, and really have some fun playing around with these highlights. For example, let's go ahead and play around with the blue balance in those highlights. If I was to pump it up, you'll see that my sky gets a much stronger blue cast to it, or go much more towards an evening scene where I'm getting some golden tones in the sky. Let's say for now, I want to pump up that sky. You can play around with the shadows. For example, if I was to increase the blue balance, I would have very cold shadows. The whole scene is a bit cooler now, and I'm kind of losing some of the nice color in the bark. I might instead say, hey, let's pump up the red balance in the shadow and really pump up the strength of that bark in the trees. Now the red in the trees pops out much more. And then in the midtones, I can say, strengthen up the leaves by increasing the green midtones. So I've done the blue in the highlights, the sky, the red in the shadows, the bark, and the green in the midtones, the leaves. This is before and after. Selectively pumped up the image. And again, I can look at preserve luminosity to see whether or not it balances out my overall brightness. But this is a case where it makes just too drastic of a correction for my taste. It's really looking at that flare and kind of misadjusting the image. I'll go ahead and leave preserve luminosity off. If anything, apply an effect such as color correction, levels, and then go ahead and bend the gamma of it to get the sort of grayscale balance in the image that I like. This is before and after. Just some creative pumping up of the image. So color balance is your three-way color corrector inside After Effects. It's pretty easy to master once you know what all these values mean, and remember to look at your info panel to help give you an idea of what color tints exist in your image. There is a better three-way color corrector bundled with After Effects, and that's Color Finesse from Synthetic Aperture, but it has a much steeper learning curve. Color balance is a good, quickie way of cleaning up or making some adjustments to your images.